In this video, we will build a DVD using Adobe Encore. To begin, open a new project and save it in the folder where the original file is saved. Next, we will import the video. To do this, go to File, Import As, and select Timeline. Then find and open the correct file. Depending on the file, this part may take a while. You can check this in the Progress tab on the far right panel. Then, in the Projects panel on the left side, select and then right-click on the video. Select Transcode Now. This takes a long time, so I'm going to pause the video and come back when it's done. There are many steps to transcoding, so you need to wait until the untranscoded turns to transcoded and all the status bars have finished. Now that the video has finished transcoding, we need to import our captioning provided by clip. Again, go to File, Import As, and Timeline. This file is found on the video drive. Transcode this as well. It should only take a few seconds. Next, we need to import the menu. Again, File, Import As, but this time select Menu. Find the menu that is an Adobe menu file. Import this. We don't need any of the extra buttons, so go down to the bottom right panel and unclick them. Let's add in our chapter points by going to the Timeline menu and selecting Add Chapter Points at Intervals. Let's leave the intervals at 5 minutes. Now let's connect the timelines of the videos to the menu. You want to connect the Play Movie button to the main video timeline. Then connect the end action of that video to the timeline of the captioning provided by. Then make the end action of that be to return to the menu. Let's also make the first play be the menu. Finally, we need to add in the captions. So, click on the video bar, making sure that both the audio and video have been selected. Holding Shift and Alt together, click again on the video bar. You might have to click back and forth between the audio and the video to get the correct menu to pop up. Now click on Browse, and find the SCC file that was exported out of Caption Maker, and import the captions. Before we build the DVD, we need to check to make sure everything is connected properly. Go up to File, and then down to Check Project. Click Start. Good, no problems. But if there were, you would simply have to fix whatever came up, and then try again. Now, to further check that everything is working properly, let's preview the video. Clicking Play should make the video start. And it does. Great. Now we are ready to build. The complete list of options that should be selected is in the manual, and I suggest that if you have questions to look there. But for now, all I'm going to change is that we want to make 2 copies. Now you can click Build. Stick in the DVD and hit OK. This will make a build window pop up, showing the progress of the build. This could also take some time. And this is how to build a DVD.